Girl gets dumped and emails teacher to explain late paper. Move over, dog ate my homework. There's a new excuse going around school, and it's called getting dumped. This amazing development was recently discovered by Rachel Harriman, a 19-year-old Ohio State University student who just had her heart broken. On the evening of February 25th, Rachel was unexpectedly dropped by her boyfriend, left alone with a bucket of tears and maybe a box of Kleenex. In her fragile state, she had trouble focusing the next day and found herself unable to complete a class assignment on time. Hoping for a touch of grace, she explained her situation to her professor, apologizing for her late submission. The email, which she later posted to Twitter, read, "My boyfriend unexpectedly broke up with me yesterday evening, and I was a complete, unfocused mess who did not account for such a time-consuming hiccup to affect my Sunday productivity. This will obviously not happen again, and I'm no longer in a relationship and will have no one to break up with me next Sunday." How sad. Her professor, appreciating her sincerity, responded in a very "we've all been there" tone, saying, "Well, life happens. Seems like a good time to go to Europe." How cool. Guess we know whose class students will be clawing to get into next semester. And as for Rachel, she got a B+ on her assignment, didn't lose any points for being late, and has received a ton of support from the online community to help mend her broken heart, including a few users asking for her help to draft up letters to get them out of their own obligations. Sounds like she's gonna be all right.
YouTube's ad policies are killing creators, but you can help. Be a hero at patreon.com/TomoNews.
When it comes to academic success, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
UCSD art student forced to perform naked to pass class. The mother of a California college student said she was bothered when she learned one of her daughter's classes required her to get naked for her final exam. The issue over a syllabus refers to an erotic self assignment requiring students to create a series of visual gestures that speak about themselves. Professor Ricardo Dominguez admitted to pass his final, his students must get naked, but the professor said, students can choose between being nude or not removing their clothes as long as they are demonstrating being emotionally naked in an erotic state. The purpose of this assignment is to invent oneself in a new way or evoke a variety of selves using their imagination. Professor Dominguez has been lighting his classroom by candlelight and alongside his students bearing it all. As part of the assignment he's done for the last 11 years, he says he's never received any complaints until now. Faculty members and former students have come to the educator's defense and back the program's performing the erotic self assignment. But the student's mother, who wished to remain anonymous, accuses Dominguez of being an undercover Chester the molester. What do you think? Let us know in the comments below.
8,000 students from China expelled for cheating and poor grades. According to a U.S. education company that caters to Chinese students, more than 80% of students kicked out of university in the U.S. were booted for poor academic performance or cheating. The news comes on the heels of a case where federal prosecutors in Pittsburgh have indicted 15 Chinese citizens for allegedly taking part in a college entrance scheme. Unlike American students, Chinese students care most about the reputation of the school, aiming to gain entry into top universities in the U.S. But in reality, many are not ready to study in highly competitive programs or enter programs which do not fit their capabilities. The survey found that more than half of the Chinese students expelled were from top 100 U.S. universities. Cheating on exams, plagiarism, and finding other students to write papers for them were often cited as the cause for expulsion. Actually, the numbers aren't so terrible, since there are thousands of international Chinese students enrolled in U.S. universities. According to China's Ministry of Education, 459,600 students went overseas to study last year alone. However, the authors of this survey said that the problem isn't about students from China and the U.S. The problem was a result of different education standards and different attitudes towards unacceptable behavior.
UNC Academics report verifies UNC has no academics. Looks like the academic and athletic scandal that saw easy A's and B's given out to athletes at the University of North Carolina was a little bit bigger than previously reported. An investigation carried out by former U.S. Department of Justice official Kenneth Weinstein found that more than 3,100 students enrolled in UNC's shadow curriculum. For 18 years, between 1993 and 2011, Debbie Crowder and Dr. Julius Nyangoro designed a cake curriculum inside UNC's African and Afro-American Studies program. The fake classes were largely made up of paper-only independent study courses, and lecture-only classes where attendance was optional. Overall, about 1,871 student-athletes were enrolled in the shadow curriculum, and of those, 1,189 were football or basketball players. School counselors, it was found, frequently steered student-athletes with crappy grades towards these fake classes. UNC is now worried its academic reputation could be damaged by the ongoing athletic scandal. Academics at UNC? Whatever.
Say no to safe spaces on YouTube. Support Tomo News at patreon.com/tomonews.
Student accuses teacher of beating him for gift money. A teacher in northeast China's Liaoning province has been accused of beating up a student for failing to organize a gift for his teacher on Teacher's Day. The student, identified by the alias Guo Yu, said that the teacher asked him and a female class leader to collect gift money for September 10th, a national holiday dedicated to teaching staff. However, Guo forgot, and the teacher summoned him to his office at 7 p.m. after class. When Guo failed to produce the gift or any gift money, the teacher beat him mercilessly for 10 minutes. Guo then claims as he was leaving the office, he slipped and injured his right arm by shattering a window. When the police investigated the student's claims, the teacher said he'd only struck Guo after catching the student using his phone in class. The teacher said that Guo was angry at him and injured himself on purpose by punching through the window in order to get his teacher in trouble. The student is currently still in hospital for treatment while police investigate.